Hello everybody and welcome to another episode of Metroid Zero Mission. I actually didn't say fusion for once, though it was about to come out. So in this episode, we got the wave beam. Which I totally forgot about existing. So in this episode, we're gonna be crossing this area now that we can shoot multiple things at once. Because now it's easy with the power of wave beam. Except this is kind of creepy now, isn't it? Kill the larva through shooting through its stomach. That are passing through. Push you back. How can I damage you, buddy? Maybe there's something hidden here in the corpse of your brother. Alright, buddy. You're gonna have to back up. Well, I can't kill that thing, but I have to kill the thing. I have no memory of this at all. Well, there's gotta be something. I couldn't just get stuck here for nothing. Can't get past him. Hmm. Well, I'm stumped. I just wait. Well, obviously not, otherwise I wouldn't be able to push this thing back in the first place. There's nothing on the ground. Oh, I see. Where are you, secret? There you are. Energy tank. There's still no way I could make that from here, but... Okay. We're actually doing pretty good on energy tanks. I thought I was gonna do way worse than I have been. The missile thing must just be a way to get out faster. Than just using the simple speed boots way out. Though I don't know, speed boots would be more efficient in my opinion. More deadly plants. This is a thing that's kind of gross. The plants that are in these dead ones. Meat. Good old whatever his name is that's in the original Super Metroid. Spore spawn. but creepy. Come on, spore spawn. You'll make sure that you have hay fever by the end of this. You're right side now. Oops. 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 It's still moving. This isn't a great thing to think about. Also, welcome to Ridley. Despite the fact that Ridley shouldn't, by all means, be here now. Rid of Lee. And her or his spooky morning music. It feels like we should have fought way more bosses than right now because of Fantoon, you know, Crocomire. But I guess it makes sense because Fantoon, I don't think, was a space pirate, just a vengeful spirit of someone killed by the space pirates. Or the amalgamation of dead souls. So I guess it would make sense that they wouldn't be necessary to fight Mother Brain. And especially since, as well, this is supposed to be her first time fighting them for the most part. Just a few more. And we're good. Oops. Remember when I first played this, I was just like, seriously, Ridley now? No, Ridley's later. This whole area doesn't really feel right for, like, Norfair. But as you can see, it's alive and still cocooning. Much to our horror. Now, I don't quite remember. Also, honestly, I might actually be, doing a lot of these things out of order. I don't know if I'm supposed to have super missiles or not at this point. Get it. What if we leave here and go back to the boss arena? Then it's been dug and eaten down. And by that time it's already cocooned, hatched, and all that. Yep. A sort of Dragon boss fight. Just gotta stay crouched and hope it hits. One's just exchanging blows, which isn't great. Come on. Gotcha. Come on, a plant was eating you and impaled you. It must have been dead. Can't be dead yet. Okay, now you're dead. But not after you murdered your children. Super missile tank! And only two of them to boot. Arm with select and fire with R and B. Open with the green hatches. First time you're supposed to get him. And you leave. But with that, we got super missiles. In the next episode of Metroid. If you Zero Mission. We're continuing into Ridley's Lair. See you guys then.